confidence interval for estimating a population proportion p. We're going to be constructing the confidence interval in this section to estimate the population proportion p. This is going to be a range of values to estimate p instead of just a single point estimate. We have a couple of versions for the interval. One is written as a double inequality, where you've got the sample proportion minus the margin of error is less than p, which is less than the sample proportion plus the margin of error, where the margin of error is found by multiplying the critical value times this square root of p hat q hat divided by n. The three formats in which you will potentially write the interval is the one just described, and then these two other forms where we've got the population proportion plus or minus the margin of error, and then this interval that is the difference separated from the sum. Round the confidence interval limits for p to three significant digits. The objective is to write the confidence interval. And the symbols that are used in the interval have these following representations. P is population proportion, p hat is the sample proportion, n is the number of sample values, e is the margin of error, and z sub alpha over 2 is the critical value. This is the z score separating an area of alpha over 2 in the right tail of the standard normal distribution. There are several requirements that must be met. One is that the sample is a simple random sample. The second is the conditions of a binomial distribution are satisfied. There's a fixed number of trials, the trials are independent, there are two categories of outcomes, and the probabilities remain constant for each trial. And the last requirement is that there are at least 5 successes and 5 failures. We're going to verify that the requirements in the preceding slides are satisfied. We're going to use use table A2 to find the critical value that corresponds to the desired confidence level. And then we're going to find the margin of error. That's how we're going to proceed to construct the confidence interval. We're then going to use the value of the calculated margin of error E and the value of the sample proportion P hat to find the values of the confidence interval limits. That's the difference and the sum. Substitute the values into the general format or one of the other forms to find the confidence interval. We round the resulting confidence interval limits to 3 significant digits. We noted that a Gallup poll of 1,487 adults showed that 43% of the respondents have Facebook pages. The sample results are N is 1,487 and P hat is 0.43. We want to find the margin of error that corresponds to a 95% confidence level. We want to find the 95% confidence interval estimate of the population proportion P, and then based on the results, answer the question, can we safely conclude that fewer than 50% of adults have Facebook pages? Assume you're writing a newspaper, that you're a newspaper reporter writing a brief statement that accurately describes the results and includes all of the relevant information. So the first thing we do is a requirement check. The polling methods used by the Gallup organization result in samples that can be considered to be simple random samples. The conditions for a binomial experiment are satisfied. There's a fixed number of trials, they're independent, there are two outcome categories, and the probability remains constant for each given point in time. With 43% of the respondents having Facebook pages, the number of Facebook pages is 639, and the number of pages for subjects who don't have a Facebook page is 848, which both numbers are at least 5. To calculate the margin of error, we're going to use our E formula. We're going to find that with a 95% confidence level, the Z of alpha over 2 is 1.96. Z-score area, 1.9 to hear you. On this side of the page, confidence level 95%, critical value 1.96. And plug that into the formula. P hat is 0.43. 1 minus P hat is Q hat, 0.57. And of course, 1,487 is N. This is my margin of error. To write the interval, we're going to take the P hat, 0.43, and subtract E from it, and then P hat plus E. This is what the finished interval would look like. 0.405 is less than P, which is less than 0.455, rounded to three significant digits. If you were asked to write the interval in the other forms, this would be P hat plus or minus E, and this would be the interval P hat minus E to P hat plus E. Based on the confidence interval obtained in Part B, it does appear that fewer than 50% of adults have a Facebook page because the interval of values from 0.405 to 0.455 is an interval that's completely below 50%. Here's one statement that summarizes the results. 43% of adults have Facebook pages. That percentage is based on a Gallup poll of 1,487 randomly selected adults in the United States. In theory, in 95% of such polls, the percentage should differ by no more than 2.5 percentage points in either direction from the percentage that would be found by interviewing all adults. That's based on the interval that we found, remember, was 0.405 to 0.455, which is within 2.5 percentage points from the 43% sample proportion that we found in the problem. When analyzing results from polls, consider the following. The sample should be a simple random sample, not an inappropriate sample. The confidence level should be provided. The sample size should be provided. And except for relatively rare cases, the quality of the poll results depends on the sampling method and the size of the sample, but the size of the population is not usually a factor. Never think that poll results are unreliable if the sample size is a small percentage of the population size. The population size is usually not a factor in determining the reliability of a poll. Here's an example. The drug Eliquis is used to help prevent blood clots in certain patients. In clinical trials among 5,924 patients treated with Eliquis, 153 developed the adverse reaction of nausea, based on data from Bristol-Myers Squibb Company. Construct a 99% confidence interval for the proportion of adverse reactions. Write a statement that correctly interprets the confidence interval. So what we have here is a request for a 99% confidence interval for the proportion. So we need P hat plus or minus E, the margin of error. P hat is going to be found by taking X over N, the number of successes in this case, which is 153, divided by the 5924. We need E, which is going to require a critical value, and P hat, Q hat, and N. We've got P hat here, so Q hat is 1 minus P hat, or 1 minus 153 over 5924, which is 5771 over 5924. And we need Z of alpha over 2, which for 99% confidence, if I look in the formulas and charts packet on the positive z-score, I could do this a couple of ways. I could draw my graph and find the area in the tail for alpha over 2, or I can look in the common critical value section on the chart and note that 0.99 confidence level is a critical value of 2.575. That's my critical value here. And then N is equal to 5924. So to find p hat plus or minus e, p hat is going to be 153 over 5924, and then e is 2.575 times the square root of p hat times q hat over n. I can use my calculator to calculate the value of E, and a decimal approximation for P hat. So a decimal approximation for P hat is 153 divided by 5924. That's going to give me 0.025827 plus or minus. E is 2.575 times the square root of 153 divided by 5924 times 5771 divided by 5924. Divided by n, which is 5924. That's the radicand. That's going to give me an e of 0.00531. To write the interval for the proportion in the double inequality form, I simply take 0.25827 and subtract E to get the left bound, which is here, 0.0205. Remember, we round to three significant digits. And then for the right bound, right boundary, I'm going to take 0.025827, and I'm going to add 0.00531, and that's going to give me the right boundary of 0.0311. There's my confidence interval estimate for the population proportion. To interpret, that is our follow-up request, write a statement that correctly interprets the confidence interval. We would say that, get it pasted here, we have 99% confidence that the interval from 0.0205 to 0.0311 actually does contain the true value of the population proportion of all Eliquis users who experience nausea. And if you look at the values in the interval between 2 and 3% of the Eliquis users overall would experience nausea, which is a very low probability and therefore unusual for all Eliquis users to experience nausea.